Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome to Brighton Lights, all about what's on in and around our city. Let's have a look at some of the musical treats in store this week. First, two of the greatest voices in the world, the nation's leading musical theatre star Michael Ball and the nation's favourite tenor Alfie Beau are joining forces for the first time. They've recorded a brand new album and are taken to the stages for a unique UK tour. The album together features repertoire from the greatest Broadway shows, as classic songs from both Michael and Alfie have always wanted to record. These imminent recordings will then be brought to life on the month-long Together tour. They can be seen at the Brighton Centre on Tuesday, November the 15th, and tickets can be bought online for £55.75. Next, the multi-platinum selling singer-songwriter Katie Tunstall returns with a totally addictive modern classic rock EP, Golden State. Produced by Tony Hoffer, written by Katie, and recorded in LA, the three tracks amplify the very best of guitar pop. This gig will follow the release of a new full-length album this September, a record that Katie sees in spirit as the follow-up to her classic debut. She can be seen at the Brighton Dome on Thursday the 10th of November. Doors open at 7 p.m. and tickets start from just £17.50. And Overheard Wise Music presents The Secret Level with Louise Cartier. It's all about showcasing a range of colourful and upbeat acoustica, ranging from pop, folk, funk, country and lyrical, within the atmosphere candlelit hidden gem of the Brunswick Cellar Bar. Louise Cartier is a 19-year-old French singer-songwriter and self-taught multi-instrumentalist. Her favourite artists and inspirations are Bon Iver and Annie Lennox. It starts at 8 p.m. on Thursday, November the 10th and is free to attend. Next, Brighton Early Music Festival has an array of musical treats for classical fans. And St George's Church hosts Guts and Glory Spiritito. The Chamber Orchestra charts the development of the natural trumpet in a thrilling programme, cafe format and picnic event. Funded in 2008, Spiritito has sought to challenge and delight audiences with innovative programmes featuring lesser-known composers alongside more established names. To see them in Brighton, you can contact St George's Church for ticket information, and the event starts at 8 p.m. on Friday the 11th. Fans of Bruce Springsteen can enjoy a tribute act in Brighton this week with a band that covers the boss's biggest hits. The event is described as all Bruce Springsteen's best-loved hits in a sweet-drenched, high-energy show with all the passion, intensity and realism of the true boss. It can be found at The Haunt in Brighton at 8 p.m. on Saturday the 12th of November, with tickets selling from just £15 online. I had a friend who was a big baseball player back in high school. He could throw that speedball by, make you look like a fool. Now let's have a look at what's on our local stages over the coming days. Shakespeare fans can enjoy Macbeth this week at the Brighton Shakespeare Company, the infamous Scottish play set in the atmospheric surroundings of an ancient church. Macbeth and his murderous wife plot to seize the crown of Scotland in this classical staging of Shakespeare's tale of murder, ambition and lust for power. It can be seen at St Margaret's Church in Ditchling on Wednesday 16th of November at 7:30 p.m. Tickets start from just £14. Next, the story of a cricketing legend who is one of England's most unlikely sporting heroes. Set in the bar in County Durham, where the eye has gone, it tells the story of the brief life of Colin Milburn. The action takes place in 1990 during Milburn's final cabaret performance as Jolly Ollie, the character he had to develop to conceal his insecurities and suffering. Produced by the Professional Cricketers Association in collaboration with Livewire and Rough House Theatre Companies, When the Eye Has Gone can be seen at the County Ground in Hove on Wednesday 16th of November at 7:30 p.m. with tickets starting from £8. Next, an extraordinary and banal plot on The Thousandth Night. explores the live relationship between a story and its public, taking its title and part of its inspiration from 1001 Nights. A story is told made live, dragged from memory by a line of performers dressed as kings and queens, wearing cheap red cloaks and cardboard crowns. The story mixes everything from film plots, religious stories, children's stories, traditional tales, jokes and modern myths. And On the Thousandth Night can be seen at the Attenborough Theatre for Creative Arts in Brighton on Saturday, 12th of November. And it goes on between 4pm and 10pm. The public are free to come and go, leave and return as they please throughout the performance. Join Vienna Festival Ballet on a magical journey with their unmissable production of Snow White. World-class choreography propels this timeless fairy tale and answers the question, who is the fairest of them all? Based on the traditional Grimm Brothers story, this ballet incorporates all the important elements, a beautiful girl, an enchanted mirror, and a poisoned apple. And there are hip-hopping dwarfs who help Snow White find her Prince Charming. This spellbinding ballet promises to entertain and dazzle the whole family. On show at Martlet's Hall in Burgess Hill on Friday the 18th of November, a standard ticket price is £19.50. Now it's time to have a look at some of the fabulous new films due to release this week. First is a heart-rending drama from the acclaimed director of Blue Valentine. The Light Between Oceans chronicles the lives of Tom, a lighthouse keeper, and his wife Isabel. They live alone and happy, wanting for nothing, until they hear a baby's cry. A boat washes up on the shore with a lost child inside. It's just over 2 hours long and is screening at the Brighton Odeon all week. Next, also at the Brighton Odeon, is a new release out on Thursday the 10th of November. Arrival is described as a thought-provoking sci-fi thriller. It was just another day at work for Louise, but then she saw the news of the arrival of an alien spacecraft that have suddenly inexplicably appeared across the globe. She's an expert linguist who can speak fluently many languages, and the army have recruited her to help them communicate with the aliens. But everyone is frightened, unsure what the aliens intend, and she's only a limited time to make contact. And how do you even begin to translate a completely alien, unknown language? Why are they here? Find out for yourself on Thursday the 10th of November. Now for a film that's already received an award at the 2016 Cannes Film Festival. This compelling British drama portrays a searing indictment of the state of our welfare system. This film is a passionate plea for social justice, bearing all the hallmarks of its thoughtful, highly political director Ken Loach. Daniel is a friendly 59-year-old joiner who's unable to work due to bad health. However, the Department of Work and Pensions overrides the doctor's report and refuses to award benefits. Daniel must be seen to be looking for a job, although on doctor's orders, he cannot accept any work. As characters try to help each other despite their own troubles, Loach offers humour and hope. It's Certificate 15 and can be viewed at the Duke of York on Thursday the 10th of November. Next, from Sussex's beloved children's author and illustrator Raymond Briggs, who wrote The Snowman, comes a more grown-up graphic novel telling the story of his parents, Ethel and Ernest. The story is now an entrancing hand-drawn animation. Ethel was a lady's maid in the 1920s whose middle-class ambitions were somewhat tampered by Ernest, who's voiced by Jim Broadbent. As they live through the Great Depression, World War II, and the birth of television, the family experience hardship, change, and great mutual fondness. This certificate PG film can be viewed at Comedia Picture House on November 10th. And if you haven't got your weekly dose of all things film, then you'll be pleased to hear the Cine City Brighton Film Festival begins this week. Cine City celebrates the 14th edition of the festival this month with the very best in world cinema and a packed programme of premieres, previews, treasures from the archive and live soundtracks, plus free education screenings and special events. The festival opens on Friday the 11th of November at 6:30pm with a special preview of Free Fire, Ben Wheatley's new action thriller. Now time to see which comedians are performing locally over the next few days. First, a comedy show about history, democracy and capitalism with Nish Kumar and Rose DeWinner. Actions speak louder than words unless you shout the words real loud, as seen at Live at the Apollo and Have I Got News For You. And this was also the Edinburgh Comedy Award nominee of 2015. The Guardian has reviewed this act as a masterclass by a no-frills stand-up at the height of his powers. You can experience the laughter yourself on Wednesday, the 16th of November at 8 p.m. at Comedia. Tickets are £14. Next, the Travelling Sisters comes to a Brighton pub. The Australian trio are guaranteed to bring you a wicked flavour of comedy. Described as ridiculous and unexpected, this act will serve you up a gang of tragically charming misfits. Ridiculous, lovable and heartbreaking, the Travelling Sisters tread the fine line between the idiotic and the profound. They can be experienced upstairs at the Caroline of Brunswick on Tuesday the 15th of November at 7:45 p.m. and tickets are just £6.60. Now, an award-winning New Zealander who has been compared to Buster Keaton and Mr. Bean. The boy with tape on his face is Tape Face, is a show the world cannot stop talking about, apparently. This is a stand-up comedy with no talking, drama with no acting, and punchlines with no words. The artist, formerly known as the boy with tape on his face, brings you a multi-award-winning, multi-hypnotic spectacular that needs to be seen to be believed. Think you've seen Tape Face? Think again. This year promises to be bigger, brighter and more spectacular. And now you can see it for yourself at the Old Market in Hove on Saturday, November the 12th. It starts at 7:30 p.m. and tickets are £17.50. Now that guy from the TV comedy shows with the curly hair is back on the road with a brand new tour. Since he's been away from stand-up, Josh Widdicombe has been working on other things, but don't worry, in his spare time he's found a lot of minor things to get annoyed about. And now you've got a chance to hear him talk about them on stage in the form of jokes. You can see Josh Widdicombe at the Brighton Dome at 8 p.m. on Saturday the 12th of November for just £19. Right, now let's have a look at some of the very best local events on offer. First up, it may only be November, but it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. And you can help get yourself in the festive spirit by attending the Fairytale Fair Christmas Crafts Fair at the Open Market. The Fairytale Fair is a whimsical themed craft fair in Brighton. The fair will comprise of almost 50 stalls selling a range of handmade crafts as they take over the Brighton Open Market. These include gifts, jewellery, homeware, kids' clothing, prints, cards, artwork, Christmas decorations, cosmetics, chocolates, glassware and more. There'll also be live performers, face painting and cafes. Shop independent and support local makers this Christmas. It's free to enter the Open Market and will be taking place on Sunday the 13th of November between 11 a.m. and 4 p.m. Next up, for all you chocoholics, a chocolate art workshop will be taking place at the North Lane Brew House. Go to the pub this weekend and enjoy something a little different and learn how to temper chocolate, decorate chocolates, hand sculpt a pure chocolate rose and mould a chocolate item. More chocolate than a semi-sensible person can eat on a Saturday morning, plus some to take home. Prices start from £35 and the chocolate art workshop can be enjoyed on Saturday the 12th of November at the North Lane Brew House between 10:30 a.m. and 1 p.m. Now, good news if you're a sewing fan. The people behind Sewmance Festival love sewing so much that they've decided to bring you a second celebration. Come and enjoy this unique, quirky, Brighton-esque independent festival of sewing. As usual, Sew in Brighton will be there running free drop-in sewing tutorials all day with a prize draw for all those who visit the stand. Entry is just £1 and the Sewmance Festival of Sewing can be enjoyed at St George's Church on Saturday the 12th of November between 11 a.m. and 5 p.m. Now put your thinking caps on, gather your friends or colleagues and take part in Albion in the Community Quiz Night. Enter teams of up to 6 people for a night of brain-teasing fun in the Heineken Lounge at the American Express Community Stadium. Questions will cover a wide range of subjects, so don't worry if your football knowledge isn't as good as it could be. The event takes place on Thursday the 17th of November at 6:30 p.m. Tickets are £15 per person and the price includes a pie and mash dinner. Proceeds will help fund Albion in the Community's award-winning work across Sussex. Book your place now by emailing fundraising@albioninthecommunity.org.uk. Now, are you curious about Brighton? Have fun discovering Brighton with 2 self-guided heritage walks with an optional treasure hunt. If you're looking for an unusual and quirky activity which gets you out in the fresh air whatever the weather, take one of our self-guided walks with a treasure hunt theme, looping around the better-known sites as well as some of the more unusual and quirky ones, which combined make Brighton a fabulous place to explore. Curious About Brighton takes place at the Brighton Centre during daylight hours until the end of the year and costs just £4.99. Or if you have a bit more of a disposable income and you'd like to see more of the city this winter, you can experience Brighton's scenic flights. From the comfort of a four-seater, three passengers can be taken on either a short or a long tour, sightseeing the beautiful countryside. With flights taking place between Camber Sands and the Isle of Wight, this really is a magical way to enjoy and experience the city. Flights take off from Brighton City Airport in Shoreham and cost £61 for 20 minutes. And now let's have a look on what's on the gaming and technology scene. Reprise your role as a supernatural assassin in Dishonored 2, the follow-up to Arkane Studios' first-person action blockbuster and winner of more than 100 Game of the Year awards. Play your way in the world of mysticism and industry collide. How will you combine your character's unique set of powers, weapons and gadgets to eliminate your enemies? The story's response to your choices leading to intriguing outcomes as you play through each of the game's handcrafted missions. Dishonored 2 is available on PC, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One and is released on November the 11th. Now, use hacking as a weapon in the massive and dynamic open world of Watch Dogs 2. In 2016, an advanced operating system networking city infrastructure was implemented to create a safe and more efficient metropolis. Players Marcus Holloway, a brilliant young hacker living in the birthplace of the tech revolution, the San Francisco Bay. With the powers of hacking and DedSec by your side, launch the Hack of the Century and give freedom back to whom it belongs, the people. Watch Dogs 2 is available on PlayStation 4, Xbox One and is released on November the 15th. Next, Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon are role-playing video games developed by Game Freak and published by Nintendo for the Nintendo 3DS. They are the first installments in the seventh generation of role-playing games. Each game will follow the journey of a young Pokemon trainer and the trainer's friend as they train Pokemon. This time the game takes place at the Alola region based in Hawaii. Pokemon Sun and Moon is available on 3DS and released on November 18th. Now, in Assassin's Creed, the Ezio Collection, play as Ezio, the most celebrated and iconic assassin in the franchise. Join him on his journey from a young man to the most legendary leader of the Assassin Brotherhood. Follow him in his final quest for discovery and revelation through all single-player campaigns. Assassin's Creed, the Ezio Collection, is available on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and is released on November 15th.
I intend to write a book about you one day.
You do, Machiavelli. Make it short.
Welcome to Constantinia, Ezio.
So that's all for this week's Brighton Lights. See you next time for more of the best local entertainment.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre. The venue for entertainment.